5 home buyer mistakes I see and they hurt. You better stay tuned so you don't make those too. Are you considering buying a home and want to avoid the mistakes of others? Well, today I'm bringing you 17 years of real estate experience. We're going to cover 5 common home buyer mistakes that I see so that you can do your research and prep ahead of time and avoid them. Number 1, not hiring a buyer's agent to be on your team. This, in my opinion, should be one of the first steps. A buyer's agent is really somebody on your team. And did you know that you do not pay for a buyer's agent? The seller pays for them. So it's really important to find a buyer's agent that you feel you can work with, who's gonna guide you through the process, that you can commit to and have fun with, and then commit together to finding the right home, right? It's good for both parties to have that commitment. And you as a home buyer are gonna learn a lot from an experienced agent, as well as have a very step-by-step process to get yourself into your home. What I see is a lot of buyers wandering through open houses, unrepresented, or even using companies where you just push a button to book a tour, and they don't have a relationship with their agent. They're not getting guided, they're floundering all over the place, and you know what? The biggest problem is they waste tons of time, and then maybe they see the house they like, and they're not prepared, and they miss out. Ouch, not good. Definitely get a buyer's agent to get going right away. Number 2 is not setting up a focused non-negotiable list. So what I mean by that is you really need to understand what you're looking for in your home. For example, maybe you need 3 bedrooms because you have 2 children and you need to have a room for each of them. Or maybe you just need 2 bedrooms, but 3 would be great. What are your non-negotiables? Maybe it's schools or a location to a park or to your office. There should be 2 or 3 really high priority non-negotiables that you will not flex on. What this does is it saves you time from searching around, jumping to different houses and neighborhoods all over the place. I see this happening all the time. Buyers lose focus, they get burned out, they have buyer's remorse because they're just not focused. Really focusing on your home search and being precise of what you want is important. It's tough in this low inventory market that we have here in San Jose right now, but if you're focused, you won't burn yourself out and you'll know the right house when you see it. Number 3, not getting pre-approved before home shopping. I don't mean pre-qualified and having a quick conversation with the bank. I mean fully pre-approved where you submit all your paperwork. You've even done your loan and lender shopping ahead of time, and you are ready to go to buy a home. There's a couple reasons for this. Number 1, you can write the best offer when you're fully pre-approved, and you have a more likely chance of getting accepted because the seller will see that you've done your due diligence ahead of time. But really, the biggest reason I see is the stress. Oh my gosh, people who don't go through that process or keep their pre-approval updated, there's so much stress about the loan in that first week or two that you lose complete sight of the home buying process, the actual home, your move. It's just too much. When you hear people say the home buying process was not fun, it's because they didn't do their homework ahead of time. Take my words of advice, get pre-approved before you home shop. Point number 4, not setting a realistic home search budget. So you go get pre-approved, you have a number that you can qualify for. Did you know that in San Jose right now, homes are selling 8% over asking? So if you can afford a $1 million home purchase, don't you think you should be subtracting 80,000 or more from that so that when you find that right house, you can make a competitive offer, right? Wouldn't that be the best? Maybe you should be searching to only 925 and then finding properties that make a match at that and you can write that awesome offer. Just an idea. Make sure you're researching with your agent and a realistic budget and search price range so that you can make a real valid offer. If you're finding this information valuable, by the way, hit a like because YouTube likes it when you like what I'm doing. Mistake number 5, getting very close and not studying the house up front. I know it can be really exciting and very emotional when you find the right house, but that's why you have an agent, because it is a huge investment and you want to make a wise investment or at least be prepared of what needs to be done at the house. I see this a lot where buyers come in and they don't realize, or they don't add in the termite repairs or the new roof that needs to come in 2 years, and they don't put a list or a spreadsheet of all those upcoming costs. Really, your agent's job is to help you look at those costs, understand what is something you need to be aware and ready to pay for now, as well as some items that maybe you should be anticipating in the future. The other thing I see is there could be red flags with the property, or maybe the seller, in most cases in San Jose, provides those inspections up front, but there's a couple things in there that you're a little unsure of. Maybe you need a further inspection, for example, a foundation inspector to come out. So, you know, how do you deal with that? How do you write the offer? How do you budget your home purchase? All of those things are really important, and you need an agent to do that, but you also need time to study the property up front so that when you make an offer, it is legit in your budget and it's something that you can stand behind and feel comfortable with. Remember, it's an investment, so do your homework up front. Comment below if you find this information to be surprising. Which point was most surprising to you? I would love to hear your feedback. And to continue your home buying search and education, definitely check out two of my videos. The first one I would recommend is How to Buy a Home Checklist. Walks you through the entire process so you know what to expect. The second video is Home Buying Prep Step Zero, which is the research phase. And that's really where you're gonna run some numbers on your own, look at neighborhoods, and really focus on the area that you wanna search in so that then you can find a local agent in that area. Thanks for watching.